Growth and survival of fish in streams is regulated in large part by water temperature. When the water is warm, the fish's metabolic rates speed up. When the water is cool, the fish's metabolism slows down. These changes affect how much the fish needs to eat, how quickly it can grow, and how fast it might transition from one life stage to another, say from egg to alevin to free swimming fry.
A stream's temperature tends to fluctuate over time, not just over seasons, but over a 24-hour period. Data collected in natural rivers tend to be very varied.
For example, in this data set collected on the Sauk River in western Washington, you can see a seasonal cycle as well as daily fluctuations. Water temperature in a river also changes over space. It changes relatively predictably from headwaters, which tend to be cooler, to the main stem, which tends to be warmer. Within this network, stream temperature varies meter by meter, influenced by upwelling of groundwater, amount of shade, type of stream bed, and incoming flows. Human actions such as dam building and cutting trees along streams also affect stream temperatures over both space and time. We often talk about a stream's average or mean temperature. Salmonid growth rates, for example, are thought to be determined by accumulated degree days, reflecting the average temperature of the stream over time. But in natural rivers, water temperature is more than just average temperature. Natural water temperature regimes are complex and variable. We wanted to understand how salmon eggs deposited in the gravelly bottoms of streams and rivers are affected by this complexity or variability in water temperature. We also wanted to know if there was a genetic component to how an individual fish might respond to thermal regimes that are more or less variable. To figure this out, we conducted a set of experiments. We designed 8 thermal regimes that differed with respect to daily and seasonal variation. We then exposed eggs from 8 genetic lines of Chinook salmon to each of these thermal regimes during egg incubation and development into alevins, very young salmon that are still attached to a yolk sac. Each day for several months, we counted how many fish emerged and we weighed and measured the fish. We found that temperature variance impacted the timing or phenology of young salmon emergence, as well as the developmental stage of the salmon when it emerged. We also observed that genetics influenced the magnitude of those responses. All experimental fish were from the Yakima River hatchery in Washington State, and yet some genetic lines had a much stronger reaction to altered variability in water temperature than others. Our findings help us understand the ecological implications of complex stream temperature regimes. First, changes in thermal variability, independent of warming, have the potential to alter the timing of life history processes. Second, the commonly used degree day accumulation model, based on mean temperature, is not sufficient to predict how organisms might respond to altered water temperature patterns. And third, there are likely to be genetic differences in how individuals and populations respond to future water temperatures. Our research opens the door to incorporating the complexity of water temperature regimes in conservation and restoration planning. For example, landscape models to predict future species distributions under a changing climate are often based on predicted climate envelopes. Our findings indicate that thermal variability might be an important component of these envelopes. Our findings could also be used when estimating the ecological consequences of human actions, such as hydropower operations, in-stream restoration, or riparian forest management on stream and river water temperature regimes in aquatic communities.